क्रिया बाबा जी नमः। In this video, I am going to share about five great elements, which are Panchabhuta, and how Kriya Yoga enhance and give control over these five elements in our system, that is human body. These Panchabhutas are five great elements are Neer, Nilam, Kaatru, Neruppu, Agayam, that is Prithivi, Jal, Vayu, Agni and Akash. In English, Earth, Water, Air, Fire and Ether. As per Indian yogic culture and its wisdom, it is said all these cosmos, sun, moon, earth, whatever there is in earth, everything is a combination of these five. Earth, water, air, fire and ether. So our body is also a combination of these five. So by achieving control over these five elements, we can achieve inner peace, love and everlasting joy by using Kriya Yoga techniques. These five elements are mapped with the chakras in our body. So the corresponding chakra will be the responsible for controlling particular element. Mooladhara chakra controls earth in our body. Swadhisthana chakra controls water in our body. Manipuraka controls agni or fire in our body. Anahata controls air, and Visuddha, Ajna, Sahaskara are responsible or connected with Akash, that is ether. By practicing Kriya Yoga, by activating these chakras from Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipuraka, Anagata, Visuddha, Ajna and Sahaskara, we can get control over these five elements scientifically. So how is our body made of these five elements? In the body, the physical things like flesh and bone and other physical things are made of earth. And this is fueled by physical material things, that is food, that is also from earth. And it body gets fuel or energy from air. And we have major glands which are responsible for all the functions of our body. For example, in intestine we have glands to produce acid, HCl acid, to digest our food. This is a fluid, that is water. So major functions are controlled by the secretion of glands, secretion of water in our body. And we have heat energy in our body, that is fire. All these four elements and plus ether comprised are responsible for our all body functions and mental functions. So by practicing Kriya Yoga techniques, we are trying to get a control over these elements. For example, by practicing asanas, pranayamas, we are trying to control this physical material things and air. By practicing pranayama, by pranic and abhanic current, we are trying to control air element in our body by activating kundalini, which is Mula Kanal, means Mula, fire of Mula. Once kundalini is activated, we can feel the heat energy which is flowing from Muladhara to Ajna and to Sahasrara. So this is fire. By practicing this asanas and pranayamas, all kriyas, we are trying to control, get control over air as well as heat energy in the body. So once this kundalini travels from Muladhara to Sahasrara Tala, all the major glands in our body and brain can be controlled. By controlling these elements, we can align our body to get stability. Well-being, joy, wisdom, compassion, knowledge or intuition, and by achieving meditativeness and samadhi, we can access ether. That will be the byproduct of all the kriyas. By doing all the kriyas, we'll be becoming meditative, and by persisting in the meditative state, we can achieve state of samadhi, which will give access to ether, that is akash. So by achieving this control over panchabhutas, or five great elements, we are trying to get control over the body and mental activities. Those will be enhanced, controlled, and can be a pathway to open more energies. With that energy, we can become meditative, and we can also get to samadhi state. So how to achieve mastery over these panchabhutas? The answer is Kriya Yoga. By practicing all the kriyas, we are trying to cleanse all this panchabhuta, which is called bhuta shuddhi. This can be achieved by the excess energy we are getting from kriya practices, by activating kundalini, if we get muladhara activated, we can get control over the earth part, which will give more stability to our body and mind. Once we get Swadhisthana chakra activated, we can get control over the water elements of the body, that is acids produced by the glands, so which will give balance to our body and mind, which will enhance the functions of all the functions of our body, like digestion, like we can control our moods, we can control our thought process. By activating Manipuraga, we can get control over properties of fire, which is the major element to digest and to give energy to all the vital parts and also to all other parts. By activating Anagata Chakra, we can get control over air, which is one of the major element to give energy to our system. So by getting access to Anagata, we can control air flow, and by practicing all kriyas, we can give these excess energies to enhance our spiritual growth. So these etherical element, which is called Akash, this Akash energy can be controlled by Vishuddha, Ajna and Sahaskara. This is totally different energy, which is non-physical. So that can be achieved by activating Vishuddha, Ajna and Sahaskara chakras. These five elements are directly related to our sense organs, characteristics, principles, and also these are mapped with our five fingers. For example, earth is mapped with the ring finger, water is mapped with the little finger, fire is mapped with the thumb finger, vayu, air, is mapped with the index finger, akash or space or ether is mapped with the middle finger. Earth element has control over or is responsible for the flesh and bones and organs. Water element includes blood flow, as well as all secretion of glands, acids produced by the glands. Fire element is responsible for body heat, and air element controls breathing operations and fueling our body by using our breathing. The space, ether or akash is directly related to our astral body, which is a non-physical thing. So by practicing all kriyas, by achieving meditativeness, then we will be getting akashic energy or astral body access. So the mudras which we are practicing are directly impacting these five elements. For example, Chin Mudra, we are joining our index finger and thumb finger means we are trying to control Vayu and Agni. That is Shakti and breathing. So sense organs are mapped with these five elements. For example, earth is mapped with nose, water is mapped with tongue, Agni is mapped with eyes, air is mapped with skin, Akash, ether, is mapped with ears. So by getting access or control or enhancing these five elements, we can control our five senses, five major operations of five senses like smell, taste, vision, touch and sound. By mastering these five elements, we can transcend this limited sense perception. So we can enhance our perception by transcending these limited functions like smell, taste, vision, touch and sound. How it impacts in our life, these panchaputas? How can we enhance our life or empower our life by getting control over these five elements? By practicing Kriya Yoga techniques or other yoga techniques, we are getting control over these five elements, which impacts how our characteristics are, how we behave, behavioral skills. We can master our behavioral skills, we can master our health, physical and mental health, we can master our stability, control, integrity, harmony, focus, concentration. By getting access to these, we are trying to become meditative. So when this happens, then we are trying to transcend from physical material plane to spiritual plane. In Kriya Yoga, we are directly accessing or trying to control this limited perception by activating Kundalini Shakti by using air. We are trying to activate the fire element, which is hidden in the Kundalini Shakti, and by activating our chakras, major chakras, we can get control over our body, mind, and we can transcend this physical material plane from physical material plane to non-physical plane, that is astral body. This is a general overview how we can achieve, how our human body is consist of these five elements, how we can achieve control and how we can enhance these five elements. By achieving this, how we can achieve or enhance our life by the scientific technique of क्रिया योग।
क्रिया बाबाजी नमः।